Hi, I'm Michael Nadlin from Market Lead, and today I'm going to take you through an amazing and advanced segment and signal strategy that will get you faster sales and a higher ROAS immediately. This will be using product performance data from Google Analytics, so you know that you've got that data all available in your analytics, so it's actually finally using it for something. The benefits of this is you'll be able to create high intent and buying signals, and you'll be able to segment those signals as well, with the outcomes of faster sales and a higher return on ad spend. This will be practical and fast. This is the one slide process doc that we'll go through together, and then you can screenshot this and use it yourself, but I've just wanted to put this here so you know that this is actually a practical thing you can do today and immediately. So to save time from blurring out the video, I've done screenshots. So when we do jump back into here, we'll just know that you want to know your product and products that you want to use for your signal. In Google Analytics, you'll be going to conversions, e-commerce, and product performance. Then you'll review those products' performance just to make sure that there are sales and other data associated with it, and even just to figure out the names that need to be used. The next, we'll build out a product segment. So then we'll follow the just setting up a segment, which will be ad segments. And then after that, you'll have to review the audience size just to make sure that it's working. And then from there, you'll be building the audience. So you build the segment and then you'll filter into an audience. And then once you've built that audience, you'll import it into Google Ads, and then you'll use it under your data for the Performance Max campaign. So, once again, to save time from blurring out videos, I've done screenshots. So I'm not going to do every single step. It's just the main ones here. The first one, the Google Analytics. So you want to be going to conversions, e-commerce, product performance. And then on the side there on the right, you'll put in your product name. And for this client, it will be thermometers. And then I've just looked back from December 1st to March and just having a look at what the performance was like, having a look at the sales and the volume. And whilst this is quite low, at the end of the day, is with products like this or any products that you're going for, you just need data available because, you know, 150 unique purchases of this for selling thermometers on product Performance Max will be way more better than just doing all your products because there are different signals and different people. So once you've done that, you'll go up to ad segment, which you'll be able to see at the top, and then you'll build out a segment. So I just call this product segment thermometers. Then I did a product filter under conditions called product contains thermometers, and then also adding product revenue per product is more than zero. And from that, we can see that we've had 159 purchases in the last, well, actually not sure what the date range is, but what we can see is that this data is valid. So the last thing you want is like building these audiences and then just set zero. So you just need to make sure that this does populate. And then once you've done that, name it and then save it. So that means you've got that segment there. So even if you want to do analysis in that in Google Analytics, you can. But what we're going to do now is create an audience. So then follow the steps on how to create an audience. And then in the audience, we'll want to be doing this. So you'll create your audience source, audience definition, and then you'll be importing a segment. Once you've clicked that segment that we just created, it will come up like this and it'll show the conditions, which we just did before back here, you know, thermometers and over zero. And then we'll do the membership duration. So we want this to be as long as possible. But just for this example, I did 180 days. And 180 days just gives us a nice 6-month window. But for evergreen products that you've had for years, you might even have for 365 or 540 days. It really depends on how long you want to run it for. But we can see for this, for example, there's been 9 sales over the last 7 days. So we can see that this is qualified. And then at the bottom, we just name the audience product segments for thermometer purchases. So whilst this seems really easy, you know, it took me a bit of a while just to figure this out because I've been using analytics for years. I just thought this would be a really powerful way to build this. So then we go to the next step, which is the drum roll, please. And we're nearly at the end. This is when we're in back in Google Ads and then we're creating the signals. And as you can see here, I've been able to import this. So this has been a really valuable audience that I can build out. So the other audiences I have are like high spending users, purchases, but now I've got another signal for the product segments that Google Ads has now for the Performance Max to maximize the sales from this. And as you can see, I've got interest in detail, demographics, and I've got custom segments. But this is a really beautiful and strong way to ensure that you've got really qualified sales-based data coming into your account. So I'm just going to end this video here. It was a short one, but it was a practical one. So just go back to the slide with all the processes, go through that, action it, and let me know how you go.